Hi guys, I know I look like a dude today, but if you recently saw my, okay, this is being super difficult. If you've recently saw my post, I literally just posted it. So I painted that shelf and I had to put my hat on backwards because it kept like hitting the top of it, and it was super annoying. Okay. So I'm trying to go live on my Instagram right now as well. So, oh, hello. Cool. Hopefully Instagram works, because last time it didn't and I'm really upset about it. So I wanted to show you that last time I talked about painting the dresser and then trying to paint this, and so it was yellow. And then I wanted to show you guys a drawer that was done. That's what it looks like. That's what the end result is going to be. So I did this without going live because I wanted to experiment and kind of see what I really wanted out of it, especially with these like scrolls. So like, if you watch my first live with this, hi. I was talking about doing it where this was this color, like this bluey, which this isn't even like done. This was like a slap on. But I don't think it's gonna happen. It's kind of just too it's too close. So I don't think there's any paintbrush that can do it. So anyways, I didn't know what to paint as far as like the blue or the orange. I think I might do the orange because it's just a lot of fun. If you also see, all my stuff is up here now. My butcher block is inside the house. That's what was up here before. My island that I'm creating is still not done, mostly because I just want to paint everything else and not this, and not the island that's sitting right next to me that I don't want to show you because it's kind of in an embarrassing state right now. And if you were like not inside my head, you're like, this looks horrible. It does. But you guys want to check out my post, tell me what you think of that shelf. Okay, let's get real for a second. So yesterday it was a really rough day because I was like, had no motivation to do anything. The house was a mess. There was food out. I didn't even want to put the food away. I did not care. I was just like feeling this immense amount of pressure from everywhere that I was like, oh my gosh. And then my poor husband, like, he is like my emotional cheerleader. Like, I just like unload on him, and then like, I don't know if he internalizes it. I don't think he does, but sometimes he's like very good at hiding his emotions. But anyways, I was just like, ugh, my life sucks. I don't know what's going on. And I was scrolling on Facebook mindlessly to decompress a little bit. And there was this post that was like 8 signs that you are burnt out. And I was all 8 of those signs. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm burnt out. And I just started. How is it that I got burnt out this early? And I love doing this. It's not like I hate it. And I just was like really trying so hard to figure out why I was burnt out. Because normally I'm like, I know this is exactly what happens. It's why I'm burnt out. But I didn't. And I still don't really know to this day. However, I recognized it. And then I just took a me day. I literally sat around and watched Psych and played Call of Duty and ate bean burritos, because if you know me, I eat lots of bean burritos, just bean and cheese, and they're microwaved. It's nothing fancy. And then I mix sriracha and ketchup together, and that's my hot sauce. I don't know, it's just something I've been doing since I was a child. So anyway, let's paint. So let's do this red. If I can get this drawer out, I have to fix these. And oh my goodness, you guys, I can't pull it out. This makes me worry. I filled these holes. See these holes? Yes, you can see them. I filled them because when I tried to put hardware, it like fell, and you can tell that it's just been like moved around so much that it has created this like big gigantic hole. So, oh, it's coming. I mean, this drawer has to come out eventually. I might have put it in wrong. That probably is what happened. So I put it in wrong, and now I can't get it out. Oh! That was a close one. That was a close one. Sorry, I have to fix my spandex underneath my shorts. But this is a really pretty bluish coming along. It's not finished. It's probably going to be darker, honestly. Get my pointy brush, which I just cleaned it because I didn't the other day and I regretted it because it became very hard. I mean, it's kind of obvious when paint dries it becomes hard, but for some reason I didn't. Yes, so we did, first we did Queen Bee, and now, and then I did Cowgirl Coral. I think I might have done Summer's Crush first. But I'm going to do that again because it's very obvious that this one's very pink. And I'm not a huge fan of it, so. Alright. So I also wanted to say that I filmed myself painting part of that shelf. I didn't talk at all. It was 6:30 in the morning. I just woke up and I was like, I want to paint. And I was like, I don't want to paint anything but that damn shelf. And seeing that I suffered, I'm going to call it a disease, burnt out disease. I suffered from it. And I'm successfully in remission. Not funny. Okay. It was a little kind of like a dark joke. So anyways, I decided that I wasn't going to paint anything else that I didn't want to paint. And you know what? Honestly, as someone who, I mean, I want, weird calling myself an artist because I just don't feel like it's art. It's just like I love color and I have a really good eye for color, especially I feel like interior design, but I've only designed stuff for myself. I've never designed something for somebody else as far as like a whole space. I have done other furniture for other people, as I am currently doing one right now. Taffy, if you're watching, hello. Your piece will be done by the weekend. I'm going to say successfully Monday should be the day I put on the final coat. And that's just giving me a couple more days because sometimes I'm like, yeah, I can get it done tomorrow. And then like something happens and I didn't get time and I don't like it, I guess. So anywho, okay. Summer's Crush. We're going to shove this inside here. And I am honestly just going to do it randomly because you don't really want it to go everywhere 100%. Plus, I'm more trying to get it in like these little crevices because I'm not wanting to pack the red in as much as I have with these other colors. And then I'm going to pack Cowgirl Coral back in too. Again, this is all like experimental because the great thing about it is I can paint over it if I hate it. And I have done that. I have painted something to its completion and I just stare at it and stare at it. And I'm like, I just hate it. Just hate it. You guys like my double chin? It's a great double chin because like it shows up in pictures and when I'm trying to look cute and when I'm doing something or when I'm talking from like the side, when I get old and like all this sags, I'm just not gonna look like a cute old lady. Like some people age and it's like, aw, you look sometimes even better because, you know, they're just so damn cute. And for me, it's not gonna happen that way. And people are going to be like, oh no, you're so cute now, you should age cute. No, girl, aging is not fun. However, I'm going to become that lady that wears whatever the hell she wants and has crazy earrings. I'm going to become Phoebe If you don't understand my reference, you suck. Truly. You don't understand. If you don't watch Friends in this day and age, even though it was like before our lifetime, you need to watch Friends. Plug it on these holes. So, that shelving that I painted, that if you go and look at my post or scroll past it, and then you're watching this, you get enthralled by it or whatever, was all painted with Fusion paint, and I didn't know if it was going to work. Because I know with, like, this paint, it's very easy to blend it. It doesn't take very much effort. And Fusion paint is not the same paint as DIY paint. It's different in that it's, like, different based and stuff like that. So, it was like, it was a gamble. And that's why I didn't really want to go live, and I really just wanted to have like my moment where like I just get enthralled in painting and I just keep going, I guess. And you know, every day is a new day. Every day I'm always like, well, this might work. And sometimes I'm like, this is gonna be a better idea. I think I need it more. Quite a lot shoved in the middle here. I didn't really get on this corner. Okay, now I'm gonna shove some cowgirl coral, get it a little bit more pinky, a little bit more vibrant. So I've been really, really thinking about this giveaway, right? Because the purpose of a giveaway is to increase the following, increase the likes, and the more likes I get, the more eyes I have, and the better off my business will grow. And that's just facts. But I don't like doing it by saying, oh, just comment a friend's name and stuff. And yeah, I like to give stuff away because who doesn't like free things? And I was struggling with this idea of what in the crap nuggets am I going to give away? What do people want from me? Not like I can, hey, here's a free piece of furniture, let me ship it to you. That's way too much money. And I don't have that kind of money. If I were like a little bit more established, then, you know, that would make sense. But I'm not that established. So my idea is I'm going to make a fall decorations basket, right? Where I just get random fall decorations, and some of them may be from Target, and some of them I might make, and some of them I might buy from other local artists. And then offer my services, right? So I was gonna put in a free live video of you pick out the piece of furniture that you want to paint in your house, and we will discuss what, you know, what colors you want, what will match in the room you want it to go in, or if you're just trying to get it off your hands and sell it. And then we will have a video live together. Well, and then I'll help you find the paints, right? Because I'm not, so the reason why I was like, well, maybe I should order the paints for them, but then I was like, but they're going to keep the paints, and that's a lot of paint. Because as you can tell, like, I have tons of this, and I'm not going to use it all. So then I was like, okay, well, then I'm going to help them find the paints they want and help them order it, right? And maybe, like, throw in, like, a discount or something to help them out if they're like, I don't have this money. Or we'll come up with cheap ways to come up with the paint they need. And then we paint together, and then I'm like, hey, try this technique. Hey, you know, it's an idea. I haven't really, you know, please comment what you think of that. Because I mean, I don't have to throw that in. It was just like an idea to, like, you know, help people realize there's other options to what they could get out of this relationship of mine. But if you're like, that's not gonna work, crazy, then I won't even put it in there. But that's the idea. So anyways, point is that if you want to help me out. You guys should share this page and recommend it to your fellow DIY friends or somebody who you know has like been talking about doing that piece of furniture, like that coffee table, forever, and they just haven't. And you're just really, really sick of it. Like, just do it already. Stop talking about it. I mean, and whenever you go to their house, it's just a freaking eyesore. There you go. All right, next we're gonna do Carnival Red. I don't really know how I'm gonna do this because with this bottom piece, which, sorry, you can't really see. Let me get it. There you go. This isn't gonna stay. There we go. With this bottom piece, as you can see, Instagram, sorry, Facebook, the top is more red than the middle. So like, how am I gonna do that with this covering like my hand? Yes. So I don't know. We're gonna see. Try it out. And if anybody knows how to fix bottom mount drawer slides, can you like hit me up with a YouTube video or something? Because I'm on like my fourth try of fixing them. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do actually, let me see. Can you see this? I'll just go right. Roll with it, see what happens. Kinda like it. So I'm spraying my brush cuts. If I spray this directly, it will make all the colors run. I don't really want that. So I just want to kind of thin this out so that it goes on a little bit nicer. So I just spray it a little bit and then just lightly go over this. I'm not 100% sold, I'm not gonna lie. I think I want more Summer's Crush in there. Oh, sorry. I don't know. It looks better on camera. I'm not gonna lie to you. Maybe I just have to let it dry. I mean, it's kind of cool that the yellow is like really highlighting all those little swirlies. I don't know where my kid is. She's taking a nap. I always come out to the garage when she is napping or asleep of some kind, or there's another adult in the house and I don't have to watch her. Because even though there is a chalkboard out here for her, sometimes I get involved in painting. I'm sorry. There you go. Sometimes I get involved in painting and There we go. I just forget that I'm with other people. And then she's off drawing on a piece of furniture I had just painted with her chalk. And yes, chalk comes off, but still, it's a little annoying that I have to watch her. You know, I know, I'm a parent, blah, blah, blah. Listen, any parent who tries to stay sane and has, like, a hobby that's not a job, which, like, as of this moment, this is a hobby, and it's trying to be made into something else, but until that time comes, it's a hobby. What do you guys think? Do you like it? I think I might shove some orange in there. It's like right now. I'm gonna shove some orange in there. And then go back over because I want more orange. That's where I did it. See, I couldn't even tell either. It's the same. Hello, if you're joining me. Hello. Say hello. Tell me what you think. I'm not, like, so right now I'm just, like, doing this swirlies. I'm not really sure if I like it. So I'm trying to shove some orange in there to sort of add some more depth. Yeah, because I think it's got enough yellow. I think it needs more orange. I need music. Okay. So I'm not in love with it, but I don't hate it either. It's just so wildly different from the bottom one. Let's see. Maybe if I get a smaller brush, it'll work. Red, just sort of get it in those crevices. Hello, today is Thursday. Ooh, I kind of like what's going on here. Can you see? You can't see. But it's kind of got a mix of them. So what I'm going to do is sort of pat this. Yes. Do you see what I'm saying? And then we're gonna get kind of
cowgirl coral. And I'm just going to go. Where's my spray bottle? Right there. Going a bit crazy. Just sort of. And do some Summer's Crush. Just sort of put it in random places. And then go back. Your head. Ooh, better idea. You guys ready for this? We are just layering away. Yes, girl, yes. Now we're going to take this brush my arm is actually hurting. I think I've been painting too much today. Then, I'm not ready. Now, thank you. that dry.
We're gonna see how it does. But I like it. What do you guys think?
So cute.
Alright, close these up. And let's finish the blue that's in for Tante. So I'm gonna take this out because I don't want it to get ruined while I'm doing this blue. And let's take this guy out. I'm gonna take my round brush today. It's a nice fat one. So, it's already wet because I washed it because I used it for that shelf, which you guys have to go check out. I'm totally in love with it. I'm just really proud, really, of how far I've come. Okay, anyways, let's finish this mermaid tail and then we're gonna go over with a dark blue. So, yeah, you can see what I'm doing. So, you see how this isn't really blended? I don't like that. So, I'm gonna spray it. And I'm just gonna probably get some of the Hey Sailor first. This brush is really big and I don't want to ruin any of my bristles. One sec. Uno a momento. This is my palette, my painter's palette, if you will. Just a little teeny, teeny, teeny bit. Don't want to go too hard. So, a good thing about purple is that it kind of goes with it. So, I didn't put on a wax coat because I kind of was like, maybe I shouldn't. Oop, scoop, there's a. Definitely when I do the Bohemian blue though, it will be dry brushed. So, yes. So I've talked about this before. But I'm actually getting ready. I'm doing the bottom and you can't see it, but that's okay. For this market that's supposed to be happening, I don't know what's going on with it. I haven't really heard anything. So I was telling David how I was worried because, like, that's what I bought all these pieces for, was for this market. And it's like, is it even happening? I don't know. And nobody can give me a straight answer. Which really frustrates me. So anyways, point is I'm trying to figure out the best website design, and then I'm going to figure out how to ship furniture, and I'm gonna start shipping nationwide, hopefully nationwide. Don't know yet. Don't really know how to ship furniture. It is going to cost quite a bit, and yes, Shipping will not be free. It won't be free. There you go. So. I wish I had a tripod, then I could move you easier, but it's kind of pain in the butt. We're ready for the Bohemian Blue. So this is a very, very dark blue. It's almost like a gray blue. Move out the way. I'm always curious to see what the camera sees, because it's never the same. Can you even see what I'm doing? So, if you can tell, I'm not getting it in every little crevice. I still want some of these other blues to come out. However, I don't want it to be a light blue, like what it's looking like right now. But I'm excited to see this when it dries. It's gonna be so freaking cute. A really loud announce, like a notification. If you also notice, I'm not doing the top first. So the top should always be done last. Because it's the first that will be seen and the last that shall be done. You don't really know what the sides are going to turn out. So. Yes. I love this boho blue. Dripping. Nobody wants it to drip. Mm-hmm. Can you see a drawing? Pretty cute. Well, hello. Anyways, I'm gonna let this dry, see how it looks, decide what else I wanna do. It's so hard since it's not really a big surface area, so it's like the sides, it's easier to see what the heck is going on. But with these little parts on the front, it's sort of not. Plus, the front isn't really where the drawers are going to be at, or the main attraction is what I tried to say. But let me show you something really cool before I log off. So, oh my goodness. Okay. These are the new hardware that I got, and some little knobs. So, that's gonna be so cute. It's like an industrial look. Yeah. Hardware is not cheap, y'all. But I'll have to tell you the story of the hardware that's going on that shelf that I posted about when I get the hardware on there. I have to, when it dries, I want to make sure I like it. And then I have a mold. Ooh, let me show you this mold. So I bought this mold. And it's by like Redesign with Prima or whatever. I'm covering like the main part. So this is what it looks like. And you don't see it, and maybe you do if I point it out, but there are holes that have no purpose really for what I have now. I don't know if it was before or whatever, but I wanted to cover them with something very pretty. So tell me what you think. I'm gonna probably paint this like an olive green. And then do like pink brushed on it. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, go and look at this post. I am telling you, you're gonna love it. It's a beautiful shelf. Maybe you're not in love with the colors, but it just looks really cool to look at. Cool? Okay. Thanks for joining me randomly throughout the day. I know that it's kind of the middle of the workday, but this is my workday. So I always have to make it out here in the garage every single day. And then eventually when I get things under control again, I will finish that dang secretary desk because I'm so excited to use it, but I need to find an accent chair. I'm getting my rug today too. So I'll just have to take a picture of it, not finished, and show you what my rug looks like with it. It's sort of in our spare bedroom / cat bedroom. I also have a great idea for my cat stuff too, but again, I have to get these things done first because they need to go out the door, out of my garage, so I can make space and room for more. Also, hey, if you guys are in the Hampton Roads area, I don't care if it's in Newport News, Suffolk. Hi, Buggy. Aren't you supposed to be? No, you're not in high school anymore. I keep forgetting that you're all grown up now. Yes. I love you, Buggy. Anyways, so if you're in the Hampton Roads area, it could be Suffolk, Chesapeake, Virginia Beach, Norfolk, Portsmouth, Newport News, Hampton. That's about as far out as I will go. But if you see furniture on the side of the road, snap a picture, send it to me on Instagram or Facebook, or text if you have my number. Buggy, you can't be in my live video. I'm about to end it, silly bud. Anyways, send me a message and a picture of it, and if you can, get really close up and personal. I'm not gonna take, like, every free piece of furniture, but I will. And then if you have anything yourself that you're just like, I don't want this, I don't care, I will come and haul it away. I will. I have a truck, I have a dolly, I have a husband, and I have neighbors. I don't know. I will figure it out. Bug, you're so weird. Anyways, so send me if you have furniture, I will take it, I will come and get it.